Hi everyone, today we are upgrading this ASUS model A541U to an SSD, which we have here, a Kingston A400. This is a model that comes from the factory with 1 terabyte unit or 960 gigabyte regular hard drive, a spinny hard drive, and it's actually becoming quite slow. So this belongs to my sister and she asked me to upgrade it to a faster SSD so that the computer becomes much faster in using it. As usual, I'm gonna start opening and actually organize here the screws by putting them in the same order that I'm taking them out. Okay, so the first thing to do is to remove all of the screws from the bottom. There's quite a few. As you see, I'm putting them here exactly in the same order that I'm taking them out, so then I don't mix them up, because not all of them have the same length, and this makes it easier to then screw them in the right place afterwards. There's quite some screws here. This is one of the models that ASUS has been making with the battery is inside and it's non-removable. Okay, so the first step is done, all of the screws are out. Also make sure that there's no SD card on the bottom, as this might get stuck in the process. Okay, so let's then open in the front. And what we're gonna do now is we're gonna pry it open with some, you can do this with a credit card, or with a small plastic tool like this. We're gonna start to pry it open from the bottom. Just unrelease, just release it, but do not pull it away just yet, because here on the bottom, you need to be careful with the flex connectors from the keyboard and from the, there's actually a connector. There's actually a connector over here, which I'm gonna pry open. It's the first one. And another connector over here, one, since those two are released, now we can fully open it. And this is it. This is our computer on the inside. We see that here we have the CD-ROM reader. This is our motherboard. This is our battery, 4-cell battery that can be replaced later on. And this is the cooler, which apparently releases the, pushes the air from your keyboard all the way out. And this is the hard drive that we want to replace. So let's start by removing the screws. Okay. Let's see if it's already released. Now we push it back like this and just gonna let it replace there. The hard drive enclosure itself has 4 screws here. They are all the same in here, so we don't need necessarily to be keeping track on which one is which. Okay, and now that we've released them all, we can see that this actually comes out quite easily. There's some. Okay, now we need to remember that since this hard drive was like this, then we need to mount it exactly the same here. So we remove this one. And we'll place it like that. Okay? Now we will place exactly the same screws. You can actually feel the difference in weight from SSD to the regular hard drive. Oh man. It's not only thinner, it's also much lighter. You can see the difference that there's a small gap here because the height of the regular hard drive is different from the SSD. Okay, so that's done. Now let's bring back our laptop. Okay, so now that we have our computer back on, we just take this, we make sure that we're putting this part, and we just place it here, and we push it all the way in, and we will then put our screw back on. Okay, doesn't need to be super tight, just a bit. Okay. All right, so that's it. Now let's close back the computer. Let's place again the flex cables for the keyboard and for the touchpad. You can actually see that here there's a TP and here there's a KB, so that people know that this is a keyboard. That's quite Okay. Might be a bit easier to put the touchpad first, unlike what I've done here. Make sure you pull down those levers, and now you just put it all down again. Okay. Go all around a couple of times just to make sure that everything is back in place. Now let's close this baby and put back all of the screws that we wanted to put. So let's start by the top. There's no particular reason to start in some place or another. Okay, now that everything is done, let's turn this baby on again. You will see that the first time you turn it on after putting the new SSD, it might take a little bit longer to turn on, just because Windows is adapting to the new disk. And here we go. That's it. So thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.